lend me your ears and I will sing you a song about the neighborhood you might be living in. We might start with a girl in her early 20s, the one who just won't give you a second look. For argument's sake, let's call her Jenny Baxter. Four failed attempts on fucking X Factor. Left school at 15 to do drugs and be a singer. Claiming she had more talent than me in her little fucking finger. Spent four fucking years as a checker girl at Asda. So fucking special, she drives around in a beat-up Mazda. Her mum ain't much better, but will be what will be. It's clear that the apple didn't far fall from the tree. But life was alright before a disease. But that's what happens when you spend all that time on your knees. Scabs on her arms, meeting strangers in the dark. It's all about to fuck up for this nasty piece of work. And when it does, I'll be the first to applaud. Cause the ones who knew her, they just got bored. Now she walks up the high street, short skirts and too much Max Factor. That's a sad fucking life of Jenny fucking Baxter. And while I'm on the subject of things that went wrong, let's talk about a boyfriend as we continue this song. His name is Sticks or Bones or something like that. Must be the name he was given before the fucker got fat. He lives in a one bedroom flat with his mum and two sisters. Funny thing is, he called his mother's boyfriend Mister. Now E and Jenny think they are one in the same. They fell in love doing lines of cocaine. They escalate their drug use to heroin and ice. Now they're cool watching sunsets from a car park roof night. When the sun comes up and the cheap supermarket wine is all gone, it's Jenny fucking Baxter who stands up and starts singing a song. But if they're happy, who am I to disagree? I'm only telling you the story from what I've seen. Romance, it's got a funny way of rearing its head. But at least they fell in love before they were dead. The story doesn't end there, there's so much more to say. Things turned to shit after her boyfriend went away. Jenny married 2 years later and couldn't be fucking told. The guy she fell in love with did 10 years for raping a 14-year-old. Some Italian fucker named Lorenzo Vasari still drives around in some replica fucking Ferrari. He had connections with the mafia and a mansion on a hilltop. He lost everything, now he works in a fucking kebab shop. Eventually Jenny moved out and lived with her brother. Guess she couldn't handle that her husband had a gay lover. Part-time in a coffee shop writing her first novel. Full-time doing favours in a rundown brothel. And that book might just be about some poor girl growing up in a rundown neighbourhood. Or some girl in need. It may not be something I'll ever fucking read. So I guess there was just too many things to distract her. And that's the story of Jenny fucking Baxter.